come in and make your fire. So Grace, as well, experienced some adversity. Her freshman year, being on C team for the Liberal was best for our program. And her friends and her teammates on JV, you know, when you find out later that it comes out that she wanted to quit. And we talked about this, you know, with her specifically on, can you imagine if you would have quit? You know, but it says so much about you that you got your hope shattered. You didn't want anything to do with being on the C team because you didn't want, you know, whatever. And you persevered through that and you sucked it up and you played that year of C team and you jumped, like Rachel, from C team to varsity. You know, and you filled in that right back role as a sophomore. And same kind of thing going into your junior year. We didn't know who we were going to be. We had no idea who we were going to fill in where. And it probably wasn't until our preseason term that we were like, oh, Grace could actually maybe be a libero. You know, when we, as we looked at that and like explored different options, you were the natural fit to that. And your progression from your freshman year as a setter to your sophomore year as a DS to where you are now, you have made so many strides. Your communication has improved so much, and the leadership role this junior experience has made us who we are. We're able to run our offense because of the defense that you were playing and the service that you had. Career-wise, she had over 1,000 digs in her career. It was like 1,200, 1,400 digs, something like that. That's insane. And really, 2 years being a libero and 1 year as a right back defender. Those numbers don't just happen. You passed a 2-2 in serve receive. Again, those things don't just happen. Those are the hours that you put in and the time that you put in. First team all conference, an all county team member. Those are things that you've earned from where you were and what you wanted to accomplish and the type of person that you are that you put in all that extra effort to achieve.
And in addition to all those stats and other accolades, you have brought a special fun personality and a different dynamic to our group that it's pretty safe to say we are all going to miss very much next year. You always put a smile on all of our faces. Other people enjoyed the conversation saying, oh, that's just Grace. Oh, that's just Grace. That's just Grace. And it was nice to be able to go back and forth with you because I get that flack a lot also. So I don't know what I'm going to do next year, but I don't have you there to take some of that. But thank you for being an excellent leader, for working your butt off, for making everything fun, turning into a dynamic defensive specialist, being there for your teammates, and we love you.
To where you were as a junior, that improvement was leaps and bounds. And again, that's because of what you did. It's not because of what we told you to fix. It's because of what you did and what you put in the offseason. And looking back now, maybe we're the not smart ones for not putting you on the outside earlier and letting you play all the way around. Because we look at your stats, you're the second most successful player in McDonald history. And you did that as 1 year as an outside, a year as a middle, and a year as a middle. And you truly embrace that, and that shows your athletic ability, but it also shows your determination, your dedication to the program. Everybody on your team knows the perfectionist that you are, and the standard that you set for yourself, and how some interesting things come out of your mouth when you're frustrated. And that's why we love you. You know, everybody, like we were saying, that's just Grace. Everybody's like, yep, that's Abby. That's who you are. You held yourself to that high standard, which allowed you to be successful. You know, moving you from middle to outside, I think your reaction was, what? Like, the shock of it to go to set in, you know, and we explained our rationale and what that would mean, and okay, I'll do it if it's best for the team. You know, but you could tell that you were hesitant because of your comfort level. Your comfort level was in the middle, and you had worked so hard to improve there, and you took it in stride. You know, there was a lot of times early on where you missed balls by this much because you thumbed away from the middle swing. You know, and you worked every day to fix that. And Dwayne was able to fine-tune the little things in your swing. You were a dominating player in your career. You had 931 kills. That says 1 year of outside. Like, middles don't have the opportunity, the number of swings, to even come close to 1,000 swings. I think you only had 120 or 21 kills your sophomore year. That means you got over 800 kills in 2 years. And one of those years as a middle. That says so much about you and the work that you could put in to achieve that. You know, and as we start comparing past players in McDonald, there's not many people who have had that many kills. The only one is probably the girl sitting next to you. And
it's me. Oh, I love that.
So, you know, you look at that too, where we are as good as we are because of what we've done and what you guys have put in. And what if you weren't the same grade as me? And you started on the front side of our rotation. What if you weren't a middle for 2 years? You would have been well over 1,000. So again, those accolades and that success is because of you. But you worked your butt off to change those little things to become who you are and carry this team offensively. And your teammates obviously appreciate the physical ability you have, but they appreciate you as a person more. So we look at 931 kills, and we talked about, which is one of the highest kills in McDonald history. 350 digs, and that's in one season, because you didn't play defense any other time. You serve received a 2-1. On the season as your first time serving. Yes, she's naturally athletic, but that stuff doesn't happen by chance. She put that work in that brought her there.
The only thing I would like to add to that is I got to have Abby as a freshman on the JV team. And just like Kat said, you were talented then, but from your freshman year until now, one of the most exciting things to watch and to see is your confidence level in you as a player and as a person. Like Kat said, you were very perfectionistic. We understand that. We have some of those attributes too. And you were so hard on yourself about so many different things as a freshman. You started to come out of your shell a little bit as a sophomore. And because of who you are and who you played around with, and this year especially, you have come out of that, you have embraced that, you have become a true leader in every sense of what it means to be confident, to let things go. How many times do we say, just let it go, just stop, just
am
get
I
out of
it,
get out of your head, it's fine. You've been to overcome those different things as part of a team that lost 6 or 7 people from last year, and not only be able to build confidence in yourself, but be able to make every single person next to you feel confident in their ability because you believe in them and because you believe in yourself. And that character and that personality and those things they have nothing to do with us. That's all you. And we are so proud of you for who you are, how hard you have worked, and for everything you've become and people around you.
Freshman was the second highest on her team. That was a team full of seniors. And stepping into that role, after playing eighth grade volleyball is a little different. And the pressure that was put on you then as a freshman, you were able to embrace that. Then we look, you know, we look forward to your sophomore year and the things you did sophomore year. As all sophomores, we ride the roller coaster a little bit with the emotions and how do I deal with adversity and how do we fight through things that don't go our way. And you embraced that and you persevered, and by the time you were a junior, there wasn't any of those emotions that overtook the game. You were able to push through those things because of what you did in the off season and what you did in other sports leading it. You know, and it's easy for people to step back and say, well, she's just naturally athletic. Yeah, you are. But you also put in all of the work to be as good as you truly are. You know, we look back at, sport has been around from 1976. 76, so that's a lot of years. And we look at the player and the person that you truly are, and it's been, you're the best player in McDonald history. And that is, how many years, 30, 40? 41 years. So hopefully it's not 41 years of a player like you come through the door again. But in reality, that's how truly special when you think of a player you are. And where you came from and what you did. And your leadership ability to get everyone around you to play with you and encouragement. And I remember my dad, I don't remember when this was, a couple weeks ago, we were during warm-ups. I said, you know what you're going to miss most about Megan? And I was like, her ability to put the ball away. And he goes, nope, it's going to be your ability to be a leader and talk to everybody. And as you look at that, through warm-ups, it didn't matter who was swinging or who was passing. You were cheering for everybody. And that was, hey, that's a great serve. That means something to your teammates. And that you were so selfless that you were able to think out of the box and know that that's what your teammates needed from you and that's what it took to be a good leader. And again, it's easy to get complacent when you were the all-county player of the year as a junior. And I think it's safe to say that you were anything but complacent. And you worked your butt off in the offseason. You guys, as captains, led them through a very interesting club season, frustrating at times, as your mom reminded me, a loss to Cadott in summer league. Those painful things that, I'm a senior and now what am I going to do? Those are the things that you led by example. You know, we'll talk about this later in our letter, but we talked about how when we lost to Regis at our home court in our Batson tournament, how we took the three of you and we're like, this is on you. That loss is solely yours. You need to put that on your shoulders and you need to embrace it. And you were like, yeah, I know, I got this. And you can just take that. And that pressure that we put on you, we knew you could handle it, but you took it in stride and you just kept going. And, you know, in between games four and five with Clayton, I said, hey, it's on you. And you're going to be waiting 10 years for this. You can embrace those moments and move forward with them knowing that, hey, I can do this because of all the stuff I've put in and my teammates are around me. And you lived up to all those moments and you exceeded everybody's expectations of what we thought a good player looked like and what a good player could do. You ended your career with 1,433 kills. Not 1,000, 1,433. That's insane. It says a lot that Abby's the next close to 933. That number is insane. And now you look at, you know, Grace, you were close. You were at the close there. those things are because of what you did. You serve received a 2.3 of the year. You have 224 aces in your career. All county player of the year, first team all conference. Those accolades speak to who you are as a player. But like we said, the most important thing is who you are as a leader and a teammate, because anybody can have one good player on their team. You got everybody else to step up their game and go with you, and that created a successful team atmosphere.
One of the things I think that stands out specifically with Megan is at the end of the season last year, we knew that the team dynamic would be changing. We knew who we were losing. We didn't know who was coming up. And over the summer, you're like, I'll go with Abby and Grace, and we're going to grab everyone else, and we're going to practice in the summer. We're going to get the girls up to our pace, to our speed. We're going to practice with them, me and Dale. We're going to do this, we're going to do this. We didn't have to ask. You just did. You just stepped up and said, hey, we're going to be a great team next year. A lot of people already put us out. We're going to be fine. We're going to work with them. And that speaks a lot for you because you know what it means to be a great team. It's not just one player. And you know you'd never want to teach that. Another thing that I think is really special is that you are so humble in giving everyone around you the credit. Every time you've ever been interviewed by a newspaper, by a TV reporter, it's always, I've got great centers around me. I've got great teammates who can pass the ball. I've got great teammates who can put the ball away. I've got great teammates who can watch. I've got great teammates who are supportive and can be there for me. It's always credit to someone else. And that is a true leader. That's a true winner. That is the essence of what our program is.
So this guy was really worried it wasn't supposed to be this long, so we apologize for making it here. We are going to be in your binder too, but it just kind of sums up our season and how we tried to put it into words. As we said earlier, we couldn't get ourselves around to doing these things sooner. So,
breathe, right? That's our moment, just breathe.
Putting it in words doesn't always come across the way that it truly is. And those of you sitting here right now know what it truly was to be part of this team. And we just are trying to sum it up in a couple pages. All right. We aren't sure where to start something as meaningful as this. There's nothing we can say to make the community experience any less, and we struggle to put our emotions into words. This banquet signifies the end of something great, and that's painful. We were surrounded by doubters and people who thought this was going to be a rebuilding year. Did you ever prove them wrong? You exceeded expectations at every level and developed one of the most colorful and successful teams in McDonald history. We're going to take you on a journey down memory lane of our incredible. We're going to take you down memory lane on our incredible journey to make a movie.
We graduated 6 seniors from last year and brought back 3 captain returners. We needed spots filled at every position. August 14th proved to be the start of something even we couldn't possibly foresee. 4-hour practices led to choosing a team that we felt would give us a run in playoffs. There were tears of joy as we laid out the team in positions. People were in different spots. The pace of the game was new to most of our team. People had big shoes to fill. Subsequently, the amount of work that lay ahead of us was ominous. We chipped at it day by day. We came in ready to work in drills, conditioning, and in lifting. Think back to how painful conditioning was. Those time sprints, the towel pushes that some of you couldn't get through on the first day, block jumps, 10-foot shuffles, all those things. It was painful and grueling, yet you still did that. Every practice was meticulously planned to have a shot at
the game. We progressed through the first few weeks of the season, and it was clear we had a special group. I'm not talking about the volleyball skill, although that turned out to be pretty special too. I'm talking about the way we treated each other. When players got tired and frustrated, you all were there to cheer them on for the victory. You challenged them to get better and stronger, which made the collective whole better. We celebrated each other's successes and genuinely cared for them. You learn to put your own pride aside and sacrifice for the good of the team. That's not easy at any level. It was vital to our success. Role acceptance was key on this team, and all of you bought in. The people you became during these 2 months of volleyball are what made us really great.
As any team does, we suffered some painful losses. Losing to Regis and Diocesan was a needed eye-opener. We learned what we needed to change in order to be successful. That loss drove you to work harder and be better teammates. Therefore, that loss is a fundamental part of our season. You learn to battle with great teams. You learn to apply the skills we taught in practice. You learn to not listen to critics around you. You learn what each of you needs to do individually to make the team successful. You learn to never give up, no matter the odds stacked against you. You learn how to be us.
experienced many more wins and a few more losses that again proved to be learning points.
All of the four losses during our season pushed us to be better. They opened our eyes to things we needed to do better. We didn't settle, but we pushed on. Due to your constant sacrifices and attention to detail, you were allowed to do something that hasn't been done by McConnell team since 2009, win a Clover Belt Conference Championship. What an incredible accomplishment that is. That wasn't given to you, you earned that. You deserve that as a payoff for all of the tears, sweat, and pain you experienced.
Winning the DJR, Logan, and also the tournament are more tributes to the work you put in to be successful. We proved to be the best team within a 50-mile radius of any size. A regional championship is another culmination of your hard work and sacrifice. We implemented a game plan, and you executed it perfectly. You controlled their power offense and did what we do best, play for each other.
Now comes the painful part. You can't take away the hurt. And as I often say, when it matters, it hurts. It matters to each and every one of you. Therefore, it hurts. Never forget how hard you worked to get where you are. Life doesn't always go the way you want. It doesn't always play out the way it's supposed to. The most painful part of sports is that it proves life isn't fair. The end of something great hurts. It hurts because of the struggles you overcame to get there. It hurts because of your love for the game and your love for each other. It hurts because after years of work, we left it all on the court, and we fell short. It hurts because of the relationships you developed with the person sitting next to you. Some other team may have gotten to celebrate your silver ball, but they can't take away the memories that you worked to create. Someday those memories will replace the pain you feel, and it'll make you smile to remember where we started, what we were supposed to achieve, and what we actually did achieve. 2 months ago, we never dreamed we would be in a position to even compete in sectionals with a team that returned their core athletes who got a silver ball last year. We never dreamed we'd be the number two team in the state. By you, we brought these dreams to reality. You exceeded every expectation we have, and that's a credible statement when you truly reflect on it. You were one of the best teams McDonald has ever had. In sports, success is often defined by the win-loss column, although we know it means so much more. However, if we look solely at that, we achieved it. 44-5 in a rebuilding year. You destroyed all expectations. And after seeing the events that transpired in Green Bay at the state tourney, it proves what we already knew in our heart. We deserve hardware in D4 or in D3. We can sit here and go through the what-ifs or the ifs-onlys, but that's not going to change anything. We can't control our geography or our division. And in your heart, that hurts. You wanted to experience state, then the team's not as good as you got to experience. We can't change that. Life doesn't always go our way. You need to know that you did everything you could have done, and you won't change a thing. You need to trust that you laid your heart on the line for the girls next to you. And in the end, that's what truly matters. You need to reflect on the pure joy you experienced in your final game, coming back from a 2-0 deficit. If we could change the outcome of the last 15 points, you would no doubt say that math was your favorite memory of your career. The outcome doesn't change the process. The process is what gives you the memories. Cherish them.
Seniors, your career record was 116.25, 88.8 over the last 2 years. Safe to say, you are the one of the winningest classes in McDonald history. That does not happen by chance. You are irreplaceable, and we are proud of the leaders that you are. Thanks for being you and making McDonald proud. You define what it looks like to be a role model. To be someone who puts the work in and day out. The picture of Abby on our floor after the career ended said 1,000 words. As painful as that is, it captures the moment of how hard you have each worked to get where we are today. It captures how much you love each other and how much this game means to you. It's painful to know you will never wear a McDonald's volleyball jersey again. But because of you, some little girl wants to grow up and proudly wear that McDonald's volleyball jersey to be just like you. And the only thing that hurts worse than losing that game is losing you. You are incredible people with an incredible sports resume. The lessons you have learned and taught will make you successful in your life. And to our hurting hurts, our dad with his wisdom sent the priest of hurting grace. He sent that over. I can't talk with him. Okay. To our hurting hearts, our dad through his wisdom sent the perfect words at the end of our season. He said, I know that you were both hurting, and you should, and it will hurt. It would not hurt if you hadn't done the right things all year long to get them there. I'm sure you remember that your ultimate goal was for those girls to become a team and to love one another. Getting to state would have been the manifestation of that goal, not the end. You know that they, with your leadership, accomplished that goal, and this was a treat. He's right. You are an amazing team because of who you are, and we give you all the credit. We coach you physically and try to prepare you mentally for the adversity you will face along the way, but you have to buy in. We can tell you what it means to be a good teammate, coachable athlete, and selfless player, but it's up to you to apply those lessons. You are successful in all of those categories. Your character was established long before we started coaching. Our great team is full of special people. Thank you for being you and for making us proud. Pre-K does not define us. We define us. We made everyone believe in something bigger than you. This is us, and we wouldn't change that for a long time. Thank you for the memories and the
Okay, do you ladies want to talk first, or do you like the slideshow first? Okay.